If you are preparing for UGC NET exams or your SET exam, this video will be very much helpful for you. In the last video, I have discussed question number 1 to question number 10. If you have not watched my previous video, links are given in the description. In this video, I am going to discuss from question number 11 to question number 20, try to score 10 on 10. Question number 11, successive minima and successive maxima will be separated by first option lambda by 2, second option lambda by 8, third option lambda by 4 and fourth option lambda. We know that successive minima and successive maxima will be separated by a distance of lambda divided by. Hence, the suitable option that is going to follow is option number A. Minima and maxima will be separated by first option lambda by 2, second option lambda by 8, third option lambda by 4, fourth option lambda. We know that minima and maxima will be separated by a distance of lambda by 4, hence the suitable option is option number C. Thirteenth question, intrinsic impedance in free space will be. Here I have made an assumption that epsilon r equals to 1 and mu r equals to 1. We know that intrinsic impedance eta, which is approximately equals to 377, which is equals to 120 pi. Hence the suitable option is option number A is correct. You have to match the following. First one, evanescent mode, that means what? Dominant mode means what? TE10, TM10 you should tell. We know that evanescent mode means wave can't be propagate. Dominant mode means lowest cutoff frequency. TE10 means rectangular waveguide will support. TM10 means rectangular waveguide will not support. Hence the suitable option that is going to follow is DABC. That is option number C is correct. What do you mean by TE10? What do you mean by TM10? Let us discuss. In TE, dominant mode is 0-1 because cos and cos terms will be there. If you are giving 0-0, then it will be a DC quantity or a constant signal. Hence, first option can't be. The suitable option is option number B is correct. 16th question, in TM, the dominant mode is first option 0-0, second option 0-1, third option 1-0, fourth option 1-1. Since you will be having both the terms as sine and sine, both the terms should be non-zero quantity. If it wants to be non-zero quantity, it should be 1-1. So the dominant mode in the case of TM, it is 1-1. Hence the suitable option that is correct is option number D. 17th question, choose the correct option. Coaxial cable is preferred for communication. Second option, what they are telling is at high frequency waveguides are preferred. Which of the options is correct, they are asking. We know that coaxial cables is preferred for communication, true. At high frequency waveguides are preferred, true. Hence the suitable option that is correct is option number A. 18th question, in microwave communication which parameters are used? Z parameters, T parameters, S parameters or any parameters of your choice. In microwave communication, we are going to make use of S parameters. Hence, the option that is correct is option number C. 19th question, Faraday's law deals with first option, conservation of mass, second option, conservation of momentum, third option, conservation of energy, fourth option, none of the above. We know that Faraday's law always talks about conservation of energy, hence the suitable option is option number C. 20th question, identify the correct statements. First option, in phase velocity, propagating wave catches the speed of light. Second option, group velocity. Third option, whenever propagating frequency is greater than cutoff frequency, wave can propagate in waveguide. Fourth option, they are talking in terms of wavelength. We know that in phase velocity, propagating wave can catch the speed of light. True. In group velocity, it can't catch the speed of light. Hence, option 2 is wrong. Whenever frequency is greater than fc, wave can propagate in medium. Correct. When you're talking about dominant mode, you have to talk about cutoff frequency, that is the minimum frequency, but the wavelength should be a maximum wavelength. Hence, this fourth option. So, first and third option is correct. That is, option number C is correct.
If you're visiting first time on my channel, make sure you're going to subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon to get instant notification whenever I upload a new video. Thank you. All the best for your competitive exams.